This is what Japanese people or Japanese government or Japanese soldiers pick on Korean teenagers.
Like okay, let's just say you're right about that. I'm not going to say you are, but let's just say you're right about that. The Japanese soldiers went to the Korean Peninsula, and what did they yank 200,000 Korean women into sexual slavery? Is that the number?
To be honest with you, I don't know the exact number.
I think the numbers I read was like 200,000.
Right?
So my question is, where were the Korean men when 200,000 of their women were being yanked off the peninsula? Mm-hmm. You couldn't do that. In today's figures, that represents 3 million American women. If a force came to the United States and yanked that 3 million American women, they'd have a problem with the American men. Where were the Korean men when 200,000? See, this causes me the question. President Park, your president now, her father served in the Japanese Imperial Army as a distinguished officer. Why would he join the army that was yanking his women into sexual slavery? These are the questions I have. So because we have these questions, that's why it needs to be put aside. 1944.
That is totally different.
No, it's not different.
I mean, wrong point.
Why is it the wrong point? Because it questions the authenticity of the claim.
Even though the current President Park's daddy,
right,
who was the late President of Korea,
who was assassinated.
Right. By his own fellow.
But he served with distinction in the Japanese Imperial Army.
At the time, he was not President of Korea.
Right.
He was just one of the civilian, right? Young civilian, right?
No, he was in the army.
I mean, before he joined the army.
Right.
He was just just one small Korean man, young man. Joining the Japanese army during the World War?
No, it was prior. It was prior to the outbreak of the Second World War.
It was done during the Japanese colony. Japanese colony was started. You know what I'm saying?
The legitimacy of that claim, because if you come here, and if an army comes to the United States and yanks 3 million of women off my streets here into sexual slavery, I'm not joining that army.
Yet.
So why did he join? So that's what the question is. Well, maybe it didn't happen as it's being said, because why would he have joined that? Well, now let's just say it did happen, as you say. They were being yanked off into sexual slavery, and he said, the heck with it, I'm joining the army, right?
No.
Then why did they elect him for president? Why would you elect somebody president who served the army that was yanking your woman off the peninsula? Why would he volunteer to join the force that was yanking those women? And then if he joined, and he did join that force, why did the Korean people, some years later, elect him to be president of the country, which they would say he betrayed by serving the enemy's army?
Right. That one is different.
So
totally
no,
different story.
That causes you to, that causes a person like me to question the legitimacy of the complaint.
Try not to bring one subject to the other way.
It's okay. Related.
Please do so.
Yes.
I mean, Mr.
How about we just leave this subject since we can't agree?
Okay. Sure. Okay. I'm trying to focus on this one.
Yes, sir.
Before you uploaded some pictures of yourself,
right,
onto your Facebook,
right,
they may be taken as an insert to Korean comfort women.
Okay.
Right. And because of that, many Korean people were very upset about.
Oh, I know about that.
Right.
Right.
Why did you, at least, I mean, even if you don't agree with that, I mean, even if you don't 100% agree with the history of the back there,
right?
But still, you know, those ladies were poor civilian, right? Before they were forced to serve as
sexual slaves, comfort women, right?
Why did you have to make fun of them, right? Why? What made you to do that? That's why Korean people were angry with you.
Their interpretation is totally wrong.
Okay, what? Tell me.
I wasn't making fun of the women, at all.
You put the back.
Now, why did I do that?
Why did you do that?
That's a good question.
Right.
You ask good questions. In 1944, the United States Army, I think it was in Burma, they captured they captured some comfort women. And they interviewed these women. And there was a report that the Army issued. And in the report said that these women were not pretty, that's to say they were ugly, right?
You even say at your Facebook, they are ugly.
Hold it. Yes, I said that. Mm-hmm. Wow. But what did I say afterwards?
I did not hear it.
Yeah. Say, selective hearing. No. Well, not by you, by whoever told you.
Right.
I said, these women were ugly. And then I said, I didn't say it. The U.S. Army said it. I was quoting, basically interpreting what the U.S. Army said. And then as a joke, because I joke a lot, and that comes with free speech and free expression. Yeah, not as far as being ugly. I was quoting the United States Army. Now, what I did afterwards as a joke, I held up a paper bag, and I put it on my head. No, I said the Japanese soldiers should have worn this or had the woman wear this. Because in the United States, it's a joke that the woman was so ugly that when you had sex with her, you had to put a paper bag over her head. Have you ever heard that?
But they are the victims, right? Would you do that to your victims?
No, you're missing. Listen to me. What I'm saying is, I was quoting from the United States Army's report. Then I went off into telling a joke. That was in the video. Now, when I was at the Comfort Woman statue,
right. It
was no intent to show, to ridicule the actual woman who served as Comfort Woman. There was no attempt there. The attempt was to mock and ridicule those who placed the statue there.
Do you feel sympathy towards to those ladies?
When you, I'm not laughing at them now. Mm-hmm. Don't get that. I asked that question and he laughed at them.
Yeah.
No, he didn't. I'm laughing at the supposition in the question.
Okay.
When you say I feel sympathy for those women, I could feel sympathy on two levels here, all right?
Yeah.
If they were genuinely forced to be sexual slaves, yes, I have sympathy for them. If they genuinely joined to be prostitutes, I have sympathy for them.
Okay.